Hey y'all, what's up, what's up, what's up? It's your girl True, and I am back with another one. If you guys cannot tell, okay, I have just woken up. It's about 5 a.m. in the morning in the risings, okay? I've been woken up 3 times, all right? This was the 3rd time, and I just heard God say, get the fuck. So I'm up, and we're about to see what's up. What are the messages? What was needed for us as a collective in this time, all right? If you are seeing this video, baby, this video is for you. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe and that bell so we can meet again. If you gang gang, you already know how we do it here. I do read for masculine and feminine energies. I read past, present, and future energies, okay? But right now, this is giving present. This is giving get up. This is what needs to be known right now, okay? At the bottom of the deck, we have Earth connection. A lot of Earth energy here. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, okay? Definitely connecting to our higher selves, all right? With that being said, we have the gateway, okay? We have spiritual growth, okay? And then we have soulmate, y'all. This is the similar energies. I have this on TikTok, but it had the music playing in the background, so they messed up the sound. And all of these cards came out. All of these cards, but I think one other card came out besides these cards. But here nor there, okay? This lets me know that we are going through some massive spiritual growth in this time, okay? We are elevating just our friendships. We're basically releasing people out of our lives that we thought would be in our lives forever, that we thought were friends, that we thought were family, right? They couldn't be family by blood, by relation, but they weren't by the energy, by the projections, by the love, right? Okay? Somebody on here with spiritual growth, I'm definitely hearing somebody's about to get their wings, all right? So this lets me know that one of our tribe members, all right, you're about to step into your gifts like no other, okay? I'm telling y'all, y'all were not guided towards this tribe for no reason. So if you are gang, make sure you guys are coming. Because there's something deep. We there's a mission we got to maintain. So I need to know everybody that's tribe. I need to know everybody that's gang. I need to know everybody that's rocking with me. All right, you're about to get your wings, baby. Like, your gifts, you guys are basically really honing in, really finding yourselves, okay? Really finding our purpose in life, specifically and especially with, like, all of this stuff going on with China. And I don't want to talk too deep into it, because they finally been kind of, I've been being a little strategic with these numbers, so I don't want to talk too much yet. But listen, all right, we are sent here as a tribe, okay? When you guys meet a true oracle like myself, like yourself, right? Because we all are front runners. This is the reason why we have all been gravitated towards each other, okay? And this is where spirit is saying, heavenly, as a collective, we need to start coming together and working together. Not out of greed, not out of, oh, let me try to get on, let me try to know. Success for long-term abundance. You get what I'm saying? To really start building, if you guys can think outside the box, okay? That is my whole objective. This is what I have been doing for 2 years. Like, this is why I'm kind of speaking up on it a little bit more lately, because of now everything in the world, what's going on. So now y'all can kind of see the whole objective of a true oracle, right? I tell you guys all the time, it's a lot of, it is fakes. It's fakes out there. It's fakes everywhere, right? But those are just entertainment purposes only. When you guys meet a real one like myself, we are supposed to build together. We're supposed to grow together. I tell you guys all the time, we all have spiritual gifts. We all, but sadly, a lot of my old tribe members that I told that, they wanted to hop into doing exactly what I was doing instead of finding themselves. And I don't want you to do that same, okay? Whether you're a rapper, stay in that rapper lane. I see so many, my old, they, now they want to be spokesmen and card and healers, and that's okay. But you heal through your music, right? If you're a singer, you heal through your music, right? If you do hair, you heal through getting people beautified. That's self-care. If you, it's a lot of other ways. A lot of you guys should be running businesses for children. A lot of you guys should be adopting children. A lot of cheerleaders and footballs and, you know, those different type of organizations. Like, we're supposed to be doing things in this aspect. Somebody on here, you're supposed to be a jewelry maker. Somebody else on here, you can sew like crazy. You're supposed to be sewing the clothes for the tribe. Like, we're all supposed to be coming together in our lane. But because we're not really actively healing, what I'm seeing is everybody seeing one person lane and thinking, oh, that's the lane that I want to be in, instead of honing in on what they're passionate about and staying in that lane and healing in that lane. And that's not the case, you guys. You are a baker. Somebody, one of our tribe members, can bake the hell out of you. You're going to come up with some cakes, some desserts, okay? That is not going to be made out of natural, like out of sugar. It's going to be all natural. Like, somebody on here, you guys, I got my medicine women. I got my crop growers. I got my, like, I need you. We need you, okay? We don't need everybody sitting here just picking up cards. We don't need everybody just sitting up here trying to be, you get what? Know our lane. And know that your lane is just as powerful, just as needed. But if we have everybody trying to do this, who's going to be out there growing the crops? Who's going to be out here finding our crystals? Because we literally need to be digging up more crystals. We need to be literally getting more, growing more sage bundles. Y'all see how much they're overcharging for everything now? For everything. It's time for us to get back into things and not do like them and overcharge each other. Because, oh, they charging $20, $50 over there. They charge $20. No. You know you done found them freaking crystals for free. Whatever you make off of them gonna be a profit. Help your people out. You get what I'm trying to say? Stop being so greedy. That's another thing that's wrong with the collective. Do keep in mind, you guys, I get passionate, okay, because I am passionate about what I do. Okay, so when my what is it? The way that I project the energy, sometimes people can misinterpret it, right? But I'm not yelling at you guys. I'm not angry at all. I'm just very passionate, and a lot of you guys are growing spiritually, okay? And I don't want you guys to grow into somebody else's calling. Do you get what I'm trying to say? You don't take that time to nurture and manifest your own. Okay, understand that we all have gifts. I was just telling one of my tribe members on TikTok the other day, their gift was to taste and to smell. And I was just letting her know because I could feel the energy, like, hey, just taste and smell. But that's just as powerful as someone who can visually see, hear, feel. Like, we got to hone in and start getting creative and thinking outside of the box with our own. That's when new gateways open, with the gateway being here. When we go into self and we hone in into our higher selves, thank you, Spirit, this is when we open those gateways to the true divine knowledge, all right? This is when we open to true divine love, to true divine connection. And that's where that soulmate and that earth connection here comes in at the bottom of the deck. But we have to embrace. These are all the cards that literally came out on Tickety Top. But we have to embrace and find balance, okay? We must embrace and find balance. But a lot of us right now, I'm getting that a lot of you guys have been in isolation. So I'm hearing celebration with celebration here. But as I'm trying to say celibate, celebration is like trying to come out both of you. Okay, there's about, wow, right behind it we got abundance. Right behind it we got abundance. So this is somebody, you may have had some sleepless nights last night. You got abundance coming your way. You have celebration coming your way. You guys already know what we do over here. We have trees as friends, okay? tree friends. We pour into our tree friends because we know our tree nature is going to always pour back into us. Somebody on here, sometime this weekend, this week, get some free time. But make sure you make some free time. Have for you. You need to get to the park and you need to go hug a tree. Go talk to this tree. Just go spend time, okay? There's going to be some celebrations come. Make sure that when this happiness come in, that you're also going to this part. And that you're grounding and you know, getting this good energy that the tree and what is it? That the tree gives out, okay? I just woke up, y'all. Somebody is stepping into their creativity, okay? And tapping into their inner child, all right? And they're actually going after their dreams. They're actually going after their dreams. And because of so, because of which, you have a lot of abundance. You have a lot of celebrations coming your way. Make sure you bask in this abundance. Make sure you bask in this in these celebrations and this enlightenment and this this praise and recognition. And not really praise, but this recognition that you are going to receive. All right? Spirit wants you to embrace. Okay? Make sure you're embracing. Somebody on here, you're about to meet your soulmate. You got soulmate imprints. I've been having some crazy dreams lately. Yesterday's dream was wild. But besides randoms, in my dream state, I've been seeing everything in twos. Everything. I was coming in my home, and they have like a dog park right next to where my house is. And it was two little bunny rabbits just hopping in the dog park like they were playing. And they were two little bunny rabbits. Every time I go live on the talk, the tick, right? Everything happens in twos. Like, if you sit there for at least 3 hours with me, you're going to catch at least two or three things that happen in twos. Literally. Like, all day that I was watching the live and both of the dudes hopped on camera and they both had on red hats. And it was like, dude, what the heck? We twins in? I'm like, bruh, it's like they're following me. So this lets me know that as a collective, divine unions, divine counterparts, divine love, like real soulmate unions, real twin flame unions, like those that have been working with themselves, just like you have been working with yourself, they are coming in. Everything that has been coming into the world, I will go online and sure that you continue to do this work so you can continue to bask in this love that's coming to you. I'm definitely seeing a lot of you guys, if you haven't, step into your inner child, start working on your inner child, start doing my stuff, you know, and getting out there and doing things that we used to do when we were younger. But tapping into that inner child, you know, playing those games with your little sisters, your little brothers, your little sisters, you know, whomever. Just get some, or even if it's by yourself, get you some color books, get you some good Legos, get you some Lego cars, Hot Wheels, you know, just do some work that you used to do as a child, okay? Just make sure that we're tapping in. This, again, as I was saying, it brings out that creativity, which is so crazy. The Most High has been having me talk a lot about creativity, and I'm in my orange today. So, creativity is all about that sacral solar plexus chakra, which is the color yellow and orange. What I have on today, it's very, 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 if you want to get more creative, start honing in. Start honing in on that sacral chakra and really tapping in and getting into this creativity. Getting into your inner child. just really going back into childhood and really just really tapping back into what you used to do, what you were connected to before the world stripped you from the little you, right? And not saying that you were meant to stay the same, because you weren't meant to stay the same, right? Things have to happen to us throughout our lives, throughout childhood, adulthood, teenagehood, whateverhood. things have to happen for us to grow, for us to elevate, for us to learn, for us to love, for us to love, for us to understand the darkness, right? Because if we never went through the darkness, we would have never understood the darkness, right? But we have to make sure that we're understanding it from the right eye, because that's where illusions are created. Shadow work comes in and knocks down those illusions. But somebody on here, you need to pay attention to your dreams, okay? They keep bringing me here to dreams. Somebody on here, you're a heavy dreamer, all right? That is your spiritual gift. That's the next one. Being a dreamer, okay, and having a gift to dream, don't feel like, as I was saying with the other gifts, like it's my new one. It's just something small or something. Them dreams are just as powerful, okay? Whoever this is, the more you tap into your inner child and your heart space, get into that creativity, right? Balance out these chakras, most importantly. Oh, excuse me, guys. I just woke up. Balance out these chakras, most importantly. You guys are just going to continue to open gateways. We're going to continue to open gateways. We're going to continue to grow. We're going to continue to come together as a tribe to build, okay? You got enchantment. Enchantment. Okay, I'm going to read enchantment from the book. Video. They've been cutting off lately, which is so weird. I guess spirit been saying, that's enough. Make sure you guys are dropping comments of love, by the way, and liking the videos. Okay, just... Oh, the video didn't shut off. I thought it was a shut off. It was a, your phone is dying. Oh, my heart dropped. Okay, let's hurry up and get to this enchantment, okay? So for enchantment, Spirit wants me to read from the book. It says, slow down. Pause to see and feel the love and beauty that surrounds you. Smell the roses. Gaze at the stars and feel the breeze across your face. Feel the sun shine down from above and the steady earth beneath your feet. Observe nature and her changing seasons. Autumn leaves, misty sunrise, dewdrops in the mornings or risings, waves of the ocean, luscious blades of grass and rainbows. Fine-natured embodied in a smile, a kindness, a sincere gesture, or a tender word. Think of someone and connect with them spiritually. Send out your love, light, and blessings. Despite all its madness, difficulties, and suffering, the world is an amazing place. Life is amazing. The sky, the earth, the universe, the great cycles of birth, death, and rebirth, all are amazing as you are. That was beautiful. So this lets me know, okay, right now, Spirit needs, the Most High needs for a lot of us to slow down, okay? We need to pause and we need to show gratitude for where we are at right now, all right? Spirit wants us, as I was saying earlier, for somebody to get to that park and go into the trees, go into nature. That's basically what this was basically reiterating. Y'all know the hell what I'm trying to say. But that's basically what this book was basically saying, and piggybacking off of what I was just saying here, with the just getting back into nature and getting back into that inner child. And just, you know, when you were a little girl, you would notice the small things. We used to eat weird things off the trees. I don't even know if we should have been eating fruits, because I don't see them in the stores being sold. But we used to eat off the used to find different flowers. I remember the little blowy things. blow, like just little things, you know, pine cones and just little things, you know, rocks and just little, you know, we used to just, when we were younger, look at the smaller things, you know, in life, and we just used to enjoy them, and we just used to tap into our imagination and just could make fun and have fun out of just the littlest and smallest things. And that's what the Most High, that's what God wants us to get back into. With my heart space is being pulled here. It's just really getting back into enjoying life and enjoying the way things out of life. You know, so many people, they think that they need money to have happiness. They think that they need money to have happiness. Everything that we need to create happiness in our life, or for us to have that, you know, have happiness in our life, we create that happiness. You create your own happiness. And in order for you to do so, you will never have happiness if you continue to look at what you have from a negative outlook. Look at what you have now from a negative standpoint, okay? Happiness is not what you have. It's not how you have it. Happiness is everything. And what you make of it, what are you making of what you have, right? And then always, never stand content, okay? So Spirit does want me to but we really need to hone in, you know, and this love first is our self-love, and then we can go in, as I just looked at the clock, to 2012 right now, then we can just go in and we can start loving the outside world. But because we have lacked love within ourselves, passion within ourselves, this is the reason why we have lost the love and haven't seen the love and luster within the world and things around us, okay? So enchantment, slow down and basically smell the roses, feel the breeze, get into the now energy. Some of you guys need to go deep into meditation, okay? Need to go deep into meditation. But here nor there, we have a lot of abundance, a lot of celebrations coming together. These celebrations, for some of you guys, I want to let you know, it's going to be awesome. Make connections. Make sure you guys are emerging yourself, jumping in, okay? Oh, somebody got a past lover coming through. You got forgiveness here. And they sent a message from afar. Oh, my God. A message from afar in forgiveness. I just had a random dream about somebody the other day. Somebody, though. I don't know if some of you guys could have had a weird random dream about this person, okay? Oh my God, I just got chills. What the freak? This card matches me. I'm trying to run from that energy. Okay, somebody is about to get a message. Oh my God, okay. So somebody is about to get a message. Somebody is about to get a message from somebody from their past. Spirit is saying to have, make sure you have forgiveness in your heart. That doesn't mean you have to take this person back. Okay? I also see a lot of people misconstruing forgiveness for allowing somebody to come back in and walk over them. No. Forgiveness does not always mean taking a person back. Forgiveness can does not mean I'm going to put my guard down and allow you to do it. That ain't what forgiveness is. Forgiveness is releasing that anger, hate, frustration, whatever it is that you've taken on from whatever they've done to you. Forgiveness really has nothing to do with the person's hurt that they did or anything. Forgiveness has everything to do with you, okay? Forgiveness has everything to do with you. What they got to do is on them. You can't do nothing for nobody. You also not opening or closing no doors and telling nobody, okay, you can come in and do this again. No, that ain't what we're saying. I love this spirit. But what you are saying is, I'm going to release whatever anger, whatever frustration, whatever hate that you may have stemmed up inside of me. I'm going to release that by forgiving you. Not saying I'm going to forget what you did. No, I learned the lesson and what it was supposed to teach me. So now I'm releasing it. Do you get what I'm saying? And this is how I can tell the levels of which, you know, those make sure that they are actually tapped in. Because I hear some of the craziest advice as I'm scrolling around here, you know, and I'm trying to get messages to somebody else. You know what? I'm just going to go into meditation. Let me see what spirit got for me, you know, because it's real dry out here. And that's because lack of creativity.